Welcome to episode 8 out of 10 beginner accordion lessons of Accordion Shop Cape Town in South Africa. My name is Stanislav Angelov. I'm your accordion teacher, accordion advisor, accordion specialist. For those of you who are coming back and following the episodes, welcome back. Thank you for subscribing to the channel and writing comments and keeping viewing more and more these videos. For those of you who found this by chance, I would recommend please go to the previous episodes because there is a lot of information and skills that we learned in the previous lessons that you would need in this lesson. The links for the previous lesson will be in the description of this video. So if you find this video useful and helpful, please remember to subscribe to this channel if you haven't done it yet. And if you feel like it, you're welcome to support this channel by following the link also in the description of this video for the site called Buy Me a Coffee, where you can support me to help me improve the equipment to produce more video, better quality videos for you to learn or to enjoy watching. In the previous lesson, we learned about alternate bass. It was something to do with the left hand, when you play the bass and its major chord, but then the button above that bass note is the fifth note of the chord, and that is what we call alternate bass. So it's a very common technique for the left hand, very common accompaniment that you find in music in general, not only on accordion. So we're going to have an exercise using that, but also today we're going to learn about stretching and contracting the fingers in the right hand. Until now we only did three different scales, which you should continue practicing. There is no new scale for this lesson. But now we're going to, besides just moving the hand like this on the keyboard, we're going to have the stretches and the contractions in the fingers. And at the end of this lesson, the dessert will be learning a song called My Body. I'm sure a lot of you know it and play, even if you've played already, check out the way I teach it to my students.
And here is the first exercise of this lesson. As I said, we're going to learn about extension and contraction of the fingers. So there are, yes, 8 different patterns that I've written here as an exercise. And the first 3 are exactly the same. You play exactly the same notes, but with different fingers. And as you can see, the notes are G, A, G, B, G, A, G. And the same thing happens over here and in these 2 bars as well. So what we're doing, the first one you will see just now, there is no anything that happens with the fingers. The fingers are next to each other. Then in the following exercise, we're going to start with the G, first finger on G, second on A, we play G, A, G, but then for the B, we're going to stretch the second finger to the following key, to the B, and therefore, again, I've got the finger in a little square and the arrows that tell you the stretching to the note further away, and then again, there is a little stretch. So what is the secret in this particular exercise and later? The reason for this exercise, this is the song that is coming up later in the lesson, is that when you stretch a finger, doesn't mean that you must follow with all the hand, all the fingers must follow the one finger. So usually we leave the first finger where it is and we stretch the second or the third finger, whatever, to another note, not to where it's meant to be. So you will see just now on the accordion when I demonstrate this. And then we'll have a contraction and stretching. So it will be always 1-3-1-3, but the notes will be different. So the first time we go to the B, then we stretch to the C, then we stretch to the D, etc., until we go up to an octave of a stretch with the first and third finger. So these exercises can be played with any combination of 2 fingers, obviously that is possible. Physically possible. So you can explore this exercise with different fingering. There must always be a specific pattern and sequence.
As your first exercise for this lesson. Our first finger goes on the G, second on A, etc. So the first two bars go like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I would recommend that you repeat each of these two bars several times. I'm going to move on to the next one. So now I'm going to play the same notes, but when I need to play the B, I'm going to stretch my second finger. In fact, I'll move all the other fingers one note away, but the first finger is going to remain on the G. So I'm doing now the second one. 1, 2, 3, 4. Is one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. And I'm going to play the same notes in the following exercise, the following two bars, but now I'm going to do them with the first and the third finger. So there will be a contraction. So G with the first finger, A with the third, and then the third will go to the B. 1, 2, 3, 4. And now I'm going to move on to the next one. So I'm going to stretch the third finger out to the C, but still starting with 1, 3, 4, G, A. 1, 2, 3, 4. And if you noticed, I don't think you can see my head, but I do look at my keyboard to see where my finger is going to go to. It is something that some accordion teachers do not recommend. Some do. I'm one of those that say that when you need to stretch a finger to move your hand, I would advise my students to have a look at the keyboard. Now I'm going to move on to the next two lines, and every next one will be one note further away, but always with the first and the third finger. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here comes the next one. 1. And the last one. And as I mentioned earlier, you can do this exercise in any, you can do it with 1-4, exactly the same. And so on. So the purpose of this exercise is now to remind us that any note can be played with any finger.
And here's our next exercise. So this is now exercise where we will use the skill or the technique that we learned last lesson, the alternate bass for the left hand. And we will also have some of the stretching and contraction that we just practiced for the right hand. Again, my advice to you is first practice each hand on its own. And once you're comfortable with the bellows changes, with the changes that happen for the hand, for the fingers, then you should be ready to continue. Try to put it together. As you've noticed now, I always, when there's something with the fingers in the right hand, I will put the finger number in a little square. So just to warn if something is happening, the little arrows mean that I need to move or stretch my fingers to somewhere else. So always read the note and the finger. A lot of students in the beginning, they read fingers. And now we have come to the moment when anymore the number is not associated with the note anymore. The secret is always when there is a stretch, do not move everything after the finger that moved. Usually the stretch of one finger or two fingers happens, and then the rest of the fingers, they stay where they are, because very soon everything will have to come back to where it came from.
I will first play not the entire exercise, but some of it with the left hand, just to remind you how the alternate bass works. And then my fourth finger is on C bass, third finger will be on C major, and second will be ready for the button above the C, which is G bass. And there it goes, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, and the same again. And at this point we close the bellows with the same C major. And now I'm going to move the package one up to the G bass and G major. And now the alternate bass. And now I open the bellows. Still staying on the G major. And at this point I'm going to close the bellows. And now I go down to C major. And here I open the bellows. 2, 3, and continue. And now we close the bellows. And now we go down to the F. And then we continue with the F and so on. When you download this exercise, you can practice it like that. You will see exactly what happens. And now I'm going to do the right hand. So in the right hand, there will be one stretch of the first finger will move from the C to the B. It will happen a few times, and that's all that happens with the right hand. But it's all marked on the sheet music that you can download from the website. So there's the right hand only. And one more thing we're also doing in this exercise, we're adding dynamics, we're adding volume to our sound. So the little P means piano or soft. Then there's an F, which means play loud, and then different other arrows that tell you to gradually increase the volume, or the opposite, gradually go softer. All right, so there we go. From the beginning, the right hand only. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, and now I'm going to close. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2. Now the first finger goes to the B. 1, but as you see, none of my other fingers moved, only this one moved there. I'm going to leave it there because I'm going to need it just now again. And I'll continue with the fifth finger. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. And now, as you notice, I moved back my first finger to the C. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, open. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, Exercise with two hands together only after each hand is very well rehearsed and flows really nicely. 1, 2, 3. I'm playing soft so far. Going louder, loud, back to soft. And now again, gradually getting louder. And now loud. And it stays loud till the end. This exercise that you can practice first separately and together. The following exercise will train you for what is going to happen in the song, in the song that we're going to learn, My Bonnie. So in My Bonnie, we're going to have a position where the second finger, the first finger is going to be on C, and then we're going to stretch the second finger one note away. But what is going to happen during that song, sometimes the second finger will be on the D, sometimes on the E. And that means that you must follow the notes and the fingering. So there is the first exercise. One, two, three. And then we're going to repeat this, closing the bellows. As you notice, for these four bars, there was always a stretch between my second and third finger. Now, for the following line, we're going to move the second finger to the E, so there will be a stretch between the first and the second finger. And again, the same thing. The last eight bars, which is actually the beginning of My Bonnie. One, two, three, one, two. So you notice in the beginning, the second finger played the D, and then you play the E, but none of the other fingers change their position. So if you manage to do this with your hand, you will be very successful at playing this song.
And now we come to the last exercise or the dessert for this lesson. We're learning a song. Some of you might have learned this song before, but here I'm offering you another take, another look at it, another way to analyze what is happening with your hands, with your fingers. Also, I'm bringing back what we learned last lesson about playing legato, slur. Remember the curved line that joins several notes, tells us that we're moving from one note to the next note in smoothly, we're not separating them. When the curved line ends, it's time to separate them, but as you can see here, we've got a D and then another D, so we have to lift the finger in any case. Whenever there is a stretch, I have put a little arrow here to remind you that. When there's something unusual happening, I have put the finger number in a little box, so that tells you something is going on, either I need to stretch, or later in the song you'll find something else, that we're actually changing fingers on the same note. The repeated notes. So this is a technique that often is used on keyboard instruments. It's used on piano as well. When you're repeating the same note several times, it is advisable to play it each time with a different finger. That helps the speed. At first it feels it doesn't, but I promise you, after a while, you will see the reason behind it. And of course, the hand also has to move from different positions. Until now, we only moved it when we played scales. Now we have this in a song. One other thing that also happens here is we haven't had this. As you see, we are in 3-4, and we've got the key signature B flat. Therefore, we learn the F major scale in this lesson because our song that we're going to play is in F major. So it's always advisable, depending on the songs that you're learning, to actually practice the scale of that song. It will help you with playing the song. So another thing that is different is in 3-4, we expected to have three counts in every bar. However, in our very first bar, we have only one crotchet, which is one count. So this is something called uncompleted bar. There are several other names in English for this, but the meaning of it is
that instead of having the three or the four, whatever the time signature is, counts, we only have some of them. In this case, we have only one count instead of having three. But what always happens with songs like this, in the last bar, instead of having again all three counts, we have only two. So the last bar and the first bar put together will give you a time for a full bar, counts for the full bar. The rest of the song, we always have three counts in every bar. Because we start a phrase, a legato phrase, on the third beat of the bar, right in the beginning, this carries on for most of the song. And as you can see, the bellows changes are before the third beat of this bar. And then before the third beat of this bar, we're going to open the bellows, etc., etc. Another thing also what happens, and I wrote it here with words, because after this music, until then our hand was stretched. We have the second finger was floating between the D and the E note. Now, once we reach this note C, we should bring the fingers together like we normally do, C, D, E, F, G, because the following four bars, we need the fingers in those positions. So from now on, you must remember that we're reading the note and the finger.
So we're going to put again the first finger on the C. But what we're going to do, we'll keep the first finger on the C and we're going to move the other four fingers one note away. So my second finger now is on E, the third is on F, fifth on G, and the fifth on A. So as I said, the second finger for the first 12 bars is going to flow between E or D, but the other four fingers will not change position. If they do, it's going to be more difficult. If you can keep them like this, it's going to be very easy. So that's how it goes in the beginning. One more advice is try not to practice the entire song all the time. Take the first 8 bars and do them many times. When you feel comfortable with them, add another 8. You will find that the next 8 bars are very similar to those. So take it one bite by another bite. Don't bite everything on one go. So there we go. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. You notice the times when the hand was moving up or down, the stretching, when the fingers suddenly came all together. So it's all written in this song that I have made available for you. And if you download it, you will get all the help written there. So there is the left hand only. So the bellows changes when I practice left hand on its own will be still at the same spots as I did with the right hand. Why? Because simply when we put it together, it will still be the same. So it's best is to always stick to the same bellows changes. And there it is from the beginning. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, B flat, back to C, F. 1 now close. go to the G, one, and down to the C, one, two, three, one, two, open, F, down to B flat, up to F, one, two, close, G, C, and F, two, three, one, two, F, one, two, three, F again, now B flat down, now we're going to skip B, G, and C, one, two, three, down to F, and carrying on, opening the barrels, another F, one, two, down to the B flat, and here we go to the G, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one. And I forgot to mention earlier about the bigger jump that we have in this song in the left hand. You saw it just now. From B flat, I skipped the F, the C, and I went to the G. So after the B flat with the B flat major, I go through the F, C, and now I'm on G. And that's the, something also that you need to also practice to make it very quick. And here is the entire song with two hands together. One, two, three. Slow. Once you can play it slow, eventually you will be able to play it in a nice tempo like this. And so on. But first, learn it slow. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this lesson, please remember to subscribe to this channel, share it with your friends who are interested in learning. Also, if you would like to support me and support this channel for producing more videos, better videos, to get better equipment, please follow the link under in the description for buying a coffee. And if you want to book a lesson directly with me online or in person, the link will also be in the description. There will be a link for the exercises and the song that we practiced in this lesson. Also in the description of this video. Thank you so much and keep practicing.